Hi everyone, it's Lindy on here from Pink Whisper Designs. Today we're going to make this fun little flop card using the brand new Birdhouse set from Lawn Fawn. So for paper, I'm going to be using the Strathmore Bristol Smooth 100 pound cardstock, and I'm going to cut two panels of this at 4 inches by 6 inches. And the Strathmore Bristol Smooth cardstock is 12 inches long, so this makes two panels, which is really nice here. So you get two panels of the 4x6, and then we're going to cut one more panel, and that'll be at 4 inches by 7 inches. And these three panels are going to create the base of our card. Now, while I have my cutter out, I'm going to cut one more panel, which will be 4 inches by 1.5 inches. And we're going to save that for later to do our grassy border. So now that I have those all cut, I'm going to grab that panel that was 4 inches by 7 inches, and I'm going to score that at the 1 inch mark. This is going to create the little tab to attach our panels together to create this longer card. So I just want to show you a little trick here. If you want those two angles to match exactly, just take that piece you cut off, flip it over and place it on the other side, and then when you cut, your two sides will be identical. This is a great little tip when you're making tags, especially. So I folded that tab back and scored it with my bone folder. So that's the front of our card here. So I'm going to flip this over so that that tab is folded up towards me. And then I'm going to draw a pencil line at that 3 inch mark. So I'm going to grab this little birdhouse, and this is from the brand new Lawn Fawn collection. And this is the Magic Iris Birdhouse Add-on Set. So I'm going back to that cardstock with the little tab on it, and I've got that fold facing up towards me. I've got my pencil line, and I'm going to place this birdhouse right on this line, just maybe from that circle opening up, maybe about a third of the way. Quarter of the way, third of the way, something like that. And you can see that there. So we're going to be cutting from that line down. So what I want to do is find that pencil line again. I'm placing this in my Spellbinders Platinum 6 machine, and I'm placing that top plate right along that line. So we're going to be cutting from that line over towards the right. So that's all we'll be cutting here. So I'm running that through the die cutting machine. So this is just a partial die cut. I'm removing the purple tape there, and you can see that we only cut from that pencil line down. So this is the inside of the card again. So now I'm going to my We Are Memory Keepers trim and scoreboard, and I'm going to go ahead and score this now at that 3 inch mark, because I only want to score right up to that cut line. So I'm just scoring the two sides. So you don't want to score all the way across here, just right up to those two cut lines. And now I'm using my Statler eraser just to erase those pencil lines. So again, this is going to create the little flop section of the card. So now I can go ahead and fold this back on those lines. So I'm folding away from me, and I'm scoring that with the bone folder. So that's the base here. So now we want to extend the card out. So that little tab we created earlier, we're going to place some adhesive on that. And then we're going to place this 4x6 panel on that little tab to create the full card here. So I've placed some 1/4 inch double-sided tape on that tab, and I'm going to make sure I line this up nice and straight, and then I'm going to place the back on here. So that completes the full card. So I'm just going to press that out. Now, there is this little tab on the back. So what I decided to do was take that second panel and place that over that tab. That just cleans up the back a little bit. You certainly don't need to do this if you don't want to. So you can skip this step, but I kind of like just finishing off the back edge of this. And that's also going to add a little more stability to our card as well. So now you can see how that's going to extend out. So I'm taking my Cloudy Stencil from Lawn Fawn, And I'm going to stencil this entire panel. For ink, I'm using the Distress Oxide Speckled Egg ink from Tim Holtz, which I love. This is one of my favorites. And I'm just going to stencil this background. And I like to kind of ink up my foam applicator and then push that ink up onto the cardstock. So I start on the stencil and then I just push that ink up. And you don't want to go all the way up. You just want to go a little bit of the ways just to kind of give the illusion of those clouds there. So again, I did that all the way down. Now I'm going to grab that little birdhouse and the topper, and there is a bottom for this birdhouse, which we're not going to be using today, and I'll show you in a minute what we're going to do. So I'm grabbing my Let It Shine Petite Paper Pack, and I'm going to take those two kind of peachy pink colors, the polka dot and the stripe as well. And for the stripe one, I want those stripes to go straight up and down, so I'm just positioning that little topper so that the stripes will go vertically. And then now you can see I've got the birdhouse and then I've got the little striped topper. Now for this bottom section, I'm just gonna run this through again, and I want these stripes to be on an angle. So I'm just gonna run this lower portion of the birdhouse through my die cutting machine. And you'll see that creates a little score line there. You can see that there. And then I'm just gonna cut right along that line. And that'll create the little bottom section of the birdhouse. I am going to run two more of these birdhouses through my die cutting machine. And for this one, I'm going to keep that center circle and the birdhouse. And for this second one, I don't need that circle, just that birdhouse. So we're going to glue these together, and this is just going to give a little bit more substance to these birdhouses. So you don't need to do this. You could just attach that pattern paper to your cardstock, but I like to layer these up. This is just going to give us a little bit more of a thick embellishment here. So I'm just going to go ahead and layer all three of these together. Then I'll add that little topper, and then I'll add the bottom section here of the birdhouse. So now with my Worn Lipstick Distress Oxide ink, I'm just going to add some color all around the edges of this birdhouse, all the way around. And that's just going to give it a nice shadow. And then for the inside of the birdhouse there, I'm just going to apply a little bit of ink around the edges. So I'm just starting kind of in the center and then pushing some ink out around the edges there, just to create a little shadow there as well. Now I've grabbed the Black Soot Distress Oxide ink, and I'm going to add a very light coating of this all the way around this cardstock. So this is one of the circles that we die cut when we die cut the birdhouse. So just very lightly, and then I'm going to add a shadow by just lifting it up and inking the edges all the way around. The next cardstock I'm going to be using is the Cilantro cardstock from Lawn Fawn, and we're going to die cut some of those little leaves, some of those little vines for the birdhouse. And these came with the birdhouse set as well. So I'm just going to die cut quite a few of those. To ink these up, I'm using one of the new Tim Holtz colors, which is called Rustic Wilderness. And again, this is a Distress Oxide. And I'm adding a little color just to the edges of these leaves, just to give them a little shadow. And I'll do that for all of these. Now we'll die cut a few flowers from the Sticky Note cardstock. And again, these came in the little birdhouse die set. And I went ahead and die cut quite a few of these. Next thing we're going to cut from the Knock on Wood Coffee Table 12x12 paper from Lawn Fawn, which is like a wood grain pattern. We're going to cut the post for our birdhouse. And we're going to cut a nice long post. That's why we need the 12x12 paper here. I'm going to cut this 1/2 inch by 8 inches. And again, that's going to give us a nice long post for our birdhouse. I'm using Ground Espresso Distress Oxide ink just to add some shadowing along both sides of this panel. This will definitely give it more of a three-dimensional look, so I'm going to just add a little ink here, and it will also take away that white edge as well. And then I'll do that for the other side, and you can see that up close. Now for the grassy border, this is the panel we had cut earlier. This is the grassy border die. I'm going to go ahead and just cut that panel, which measured 4 inches by 1.5 inches, and we cut that earlier on there. So I'm going to go ahead and die cut that. And to ink that up, I'm using Twisted Citron and Rustic Wilderness. I'm just going to apply the Twisted Citron all over this panel, and then I'll take a little bit of that Rustic Wilderness and just apply it down towards the bottom and the sides. And then I'll go back to the Twisted Citron applicator and just blend those two together. Now I'm taking the rainbow paper pack and I'm going to take that pinky color one. And I'm running that little heart through. And again, this heart also came with the birdhouse set. And I die cut 3 of those. And I'm just going to glue those together. And then I'll attach that right at the top of the birdhouse here. I'm just using my Lawn Fawn glue tube to do the gluing here. So that's the little bird we're going to place in the birdhouse here. And you can see this set has all these cute little sentiments as well. And this is called the Special Delivery Set, which is another brand new set. And I'm going to go ahead and stamp the wings and the little bird. And they do have 2 sets of wings for this set. I'm going to grab those ones that are kind of closer to his body, but they do have the wings that are open as well. Now with yellow, pale yellow, bright yellow, and tea rose, I'm going to color this in. And I'm using the Zig Clean Color Real Brush Pens to do my coloring. I'm using the blender pen to do my blending. And here I'm adding the 2 colors together, the light yellow and the darker yellow, and then I'm just going to go ahead and blend that out, kind of keeping the center the lightest. And I'll just gently blend those cheeks in, and then I'll add a little bit of that bright yellow to the beak and then the feet as well. And again, just taking that tea rose and blending it in. And then I'll just quickly color the 2 little wings. And those will get attached here in a second. I'm going to grab the coordinating dies. I'll tape those down with a little bit of purple tape. And then I'll run those through the Sizzix Sidekick machine. So I'll just go ahead and quickly attach those 2 together. Now with my Tombow permanent adhesive, I'm just going to put a little bit down on my Misty just to hold that paper in place. Then I'm going back to that same stamp set and I'm grabbing the words that say lots of love. So I've angled those in my Misty to kind of go around the shape of that circle. So just play around with that a little bit until you get it on there just right. And then I'm going to go ahead and ink that up with the VersaFine Onyx Black ink. And I'll stamp that. Now I need another sentiment for the bottom of the card. And this is the How You Been Conversation Heart add-on set. And it says Happy Valentine's Day. And I also grabbed that little tiny heart as well. So I'm just going to stamp this right along the very bottom of the grassy border. And now we can start assembling this card. So I've got this long post And I'm using my ATG 700 tape just to run that down this entire panel. And then I'm going to make sure this is centered. So I'm just laying it on my glass media mat just to find the center here. And I'm going to run that all the way up to that opening on the birdhouse. And then I'll just cut away any excess. So it's a little bit shorter than the 8 inches that we cut. Now I can go ahead and attach the birdhouse, and we're just going to line it up with the cut that's already there. You do want to put plenty of adhesive on this because it is going to get moved around up and down a lot as the card gets opened and closed. So just make sure you put enough glue on there and then make sure you center it right on that little opening. And I'm just pressing that out with some scrap paper. Now we can go ahead and add the grassy border. And then I'll put that circle right in the center here. Just making sure I have glue all the way up to the edges there. And then I'm going to use my bone folder just to press that right into place there. That's going to drop down nicely into that little opening. Now we can add our little chick, and I'm going to cut some foam mounting tape just to pop this up just a little bit here. The next thing I want to do is add all these little vines coming up the post. And I couldn't decide here if I wanted them to go all the way up that post, but I kind of decided I'd just go up a little ways and then just add some extras of these little vines down at the bottom so we could add some a little more interest down here along this grassy border. So I'm just going to, again, add plenty of glue on the back of all of these and then just position these down. Now we can add our little flowers to these vines. And you do want to make sure that you put plenty of glue there because those little centers do pop out. I'm just keeping them in place. So put glue on the center and on the flower as well just to make sure that they don't come loose. And then I'm going back to the bright yellow and adding a little bit of that color to the center of each of those flowers. And for that little heart on the birdhouse, I'm going to use the Nouveau Dream Drops in the Cloud 9, which is a really pretty pearly look. So it's going to let a little of that pink color come through, and then it'll dry with a really pretty pearl finish on it. Next stamp I want is that little word bubble with the heart in it. And that is from the Love Letters Stampin' Die Set, and there is a coordinating die for that little word bubble. So I'm going to go ahead and stamp that with my Worn Lipstick Distress Oxide ink. And then I'm going to go ahead and die cut that with that coordinating die. I will pop that up with a little bit of foam mounting tape. And I just thought that added a little something special there inside that little opening. So now I did decide to use a few more of the vines and flowers on the top of my birdhouse. I just thought it looked a little plain and I wanted to bring some more of that yellow color up towards the top. So I added a few more vines and flowers there. Now with my Nouveau Aqua Shimmer pen in the Glitter Gloss, which is just a clear sparkly pen, you do want to make sure you shake that really well. I'm just going to add a little sparkle to the center of each of these little flowers. And the ones on the top as well. And then I will add a little sparkle to his nose. And you do want to make sure you clean this off on some scrap paper before you go to your next image, just to make sure you don't transfer any of that yellow color. And then I'm putting a little bit of that in the center of that heart. So let me give you a closer look at the card You can see that pretty pearl finish we have on that little heart. And all the detail we have here, I just think this birdhouse is so cute and I couldn't wait to do this little flap card. So when this card is closed, it measures 4 by 6 inches, so it will fit into a standard A4 size envelope. That envelope will measure 4.5 inches by 6.5 inches. If you enjoyed today's video, please hit the like button and subscribe. And don't forget to visit me at pinkwhisperdesigns.com. As always, thank you so much for joining me today. Have a great day. Bye-bye.